the DEXIS intraoral scanner, capturing a buccal scan recorded class. This recorded class is designed for clinical team members. It provides instruction on capturing buccal bite scan using the DEXIS intraoral scanner. By the end of this recorded class, you will learn how to successfully capture multiple buccal bite scans using the DEXIS intraoral scanner. In this recorded class, we will explore the process of capturing a buccal impression. In this case, we have scanned both the upper and lower quadrants. Before proceeding with the scan, make sure you have scanned the buccal surfaces thoroughly. When you scan the buccal bite, align the scanner with the occlusal plane. Position the scanner in the center of the occlusal plane. While touching the teeth, glide the scanner up and down, past the gingival margin, until the two arches come together. If the scanner is not aligned with the occlusal plane, as seen here, glide the scanner toward the opposing arch. Continue moving the scanner up and down until the two arches come together. Furthermore, if you place the scanner on the buccal surface of one arch, do not move the scanner mesially or distally. Shifting mesially or distally won't yield the desired bite. Instead, move toward the opposing arch, and you'll obtain the complete bite. For a quadrant, it's important to obtain three buccal bite scans. You can review these scans using the occlusion gallery. The first scan is here, the second one is here, and here is the third scan. The blue area represents the data that were used to capture the third bite. It's important to capture each buccal bite across the quadrant, as this provides multiple reference points for the software, which will average these bites together. Now you can examine the occlusal surfaces of these buccal bites to check where there might be some teeth or cusp tips sticking through towards the other side. A small amount of this is acceptable, as seen here. However, if there is significant misalignment, it's necessary to redo the incorrect bite. For instance, in this third bite, cusp tips are slightly more visible. However, this is why we take three bites. The software averages these bites, and you can later evaluate the occlusal surfaces from both below and above to judge the accuracy of the bite. In this case, the patient accidentally opened their mouth during the bite capture, as shown here. That's why it's important to select and review each one of these bites and make sure that the bite looks accurate. In this example, the fourth bite is not correct, and we need to delete it because an incorrect bite can affect the accuracy of the bite. Deleting an individual bite is simple. Select it and click the Delete button. Now, let's look at a full arch scan. As seen here, the buccal surfaces are well defined. Instead of taking three buccal bites across a quadrant, we'll take four buccal bites, two on each side, premolar and molar. Place the scanner on the buccal surface of the premolar and glide the scanner up and down to bring the arches together. Wait until the buccal bite appears in the occlusal gallery before acquiring the next bite. We will now move the scanner a little more distal and glide the scanner up and down until the arches come together. Repeat the process on the other side. Here is one. Here is the other. If you encounter issues with capturing the bite immediately when moving toward the opposing arch, adjust your position slightly mesially or distally. For an anterior scan, it is recommended to scan from first premolar to first premolar. Then the buccal bite registration can be acquired in the premolar region of each side as well as in the anterior region. Please note, it is not recommended to include the anterior teeth in a buccal bite registration if the teeth are edge to edge. Once again, assess each of the bites from above and below to ensure accuracy before proceeding. When ready, select Check and proceed with refinement. Afterward, review the final result, here, with a finished model. On the screen, it is important to look and make sure that the holes where the cusps are sticking through are small, like we have here. Also make sure that there's no open bite anywhere as well. To confirm the quality of your scan, use the occlusion proximity tool. The color legend indicates where the bite is in contact. If you notice purple areas, it signifies over-occlusion or possible incorrect intersection of bites. In such cases, go back, locate the incorrect bite, and delete it if necessary. This tool provides a reliable confirmation of your scan quality beyond visual inspection. If everything appears satisfactory, you can proceed by either selecting the Export button to explore export options for your scan, or by choosing the Close button to save the case and export it later. This concludes the DEXIS Intraoral Scanner, Capturing a Buccal Scan Recorded class.